Before today's video begins, make sure if you're buying Robux, you use my star code Matrix whenever you do so. It helps support me and it helps create more videos. Yo, welcome back to the channel, everybody. Welcome to some more Vehicle Legends. Today, we are going over the official update to the game, more than just the map. I looked back on the video that we did, and we were covering basically everything, but we didn't touch on most of the cool stuff, like the new private jet, the speedboat being remodeled, the raceboat remodeled. There's a lot of stuff that I want to take a look at today. I also want to get an aerial view of the entire map, so we're going to hop into a plane, look around the map, and really get a good idea to see just how much has really changed. And honestly, it's a really good update. It's a really good update, new map. It's something that clearly took a very long time, because I know Vehicle Legends took a bit of a hiatus from social media and updates and all sorts of stuff. So now we finally got what he's been working on, and I'm really, really excited about it. If you guys want more Vehicle Legends, by the way, just let me know. But yeah, I'm just excited to get into this, guys. Let's take a look. We did already look at the new car, which I believe was a Supra. Okay, so this was the car that was new, and I believe this is an RX-7. I don't really know, but you guys can see one of the things I really, really like about Vehicle Legends is the amount of detail that goes into each model, even to the point where the steering wheel is actually the Vehicle Legends logo, as well as the actual dash. You guys might be able to see that there. But it says Vehicle Legends. It's really cool how custom things have gotten for this game. And again, you can see the entire engine bay. Whatever modeler he has doing all this work does an insanely good job, and the quality is very good. I mean, even the Bugatti Bolide. I actually think that this Bugatti Bolide kind of almost looks better than the original in some ways. Some ways it doesn't, but the front end I really, really like. But the new car that was added isn't really that exciting, let's be completely honest here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and we'll just hop into something else. Maybe we'll hop into this this exclusive egg car here, and then we're gonna head over to the plane dealership. I don't actually know where that is. Where is the plane dealership? Okay, over here. This is one of the things that makes this game really, really good, is you can kind of figure out where everything is. Let's go exploring, though. I think we looked around quite a bit, but this time I really want to take some time and really focus on the detail of the map, because things are changing all the time now, and it's hard to focus on what's new. I definitely like the terrain changes, the elevation. We're heading into now like an airplane airport hangar, and this is super, super cool. I love using this little egg bike as well. It's super funny. I think this was like an April Fool's update or something, but either way, here we are. Let's take a look at this new private jet. I'm really, really excited. What's it look like? Where can we buy it? Okay, here we are. We found the airport dealership. So let's take a look. I'm guessing it's the Deluxo jet. I'm almost certain it is. Okay, we already own it actually somehow, but it's been completely remodeled. So let's pull it out. Aircraft, Deluxo jet. Okay, I'm super excited about this. Can we get an interior shot of this plane? Let's see. Let's see if we can kind of get in here. Oh yeah, we can sit in the seats. Okay, sick. Let's hop into, I don't know, maybe this seat. Okay, here we go. So this is the inside of the private jet. You guys can actually see like there's different like cups and plates and stuff like that. We're gonna have to kind of do some jumping around here, but can we get into the back? Is there anything back here? No, okay, nothing in the back end there, but let's see. Oh, there's a laptop in this spot. Let's get on top of that. There's the laptop. You guys can see it has like a whole bunch of images and stuff like that. That'd be really cool if he had like the Roblox game page for Vehicle Legends, just as a small little Easter egg in this little screen. How cool would that be? I love the little Easter eggs, but anyways, let's hop into the first person. We'll change our camera perspective. Look at this interior, guys. Oh my god. Okay, so I guess we're just gonna go ahead and take off. We're gonna start. Okay, let's flick all of these buttons so that we have it going up. We are now clear for takeoff, and we are soaring into the skies, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. I love the noise as well. It's kind of loud, I won't lie, but obviously flying a plane isn't supposed to be quiet. All right, so let's get out of this perspective here, and let's just take in this map, guys. We have the entire like canyon desert biome over there. And in between, we have the airport hangar, we have a mountainous area up here, a farm kind of kind of like off-road race. Then we've got the big circuit race here, as well as some highways. Okay, hold on, let's turn around. This map is no joke. It's absolutely enormous. Also, I really like the controls for flying planes and stuff like that. I think it's really, really easy to learn. So here's the area where you go up through these like mountain passes. You get to this parking lot, or you can keep going up even further. Okay, let's see, where does this lead to? Where does this road go? Okay, there's an intersection, and then we can go either left or right. Right brings you back down. Left brings you through this kind of foresty area. I really like the size of the trees. It kind of adds to the whole scale of the map. This is really good. Like, obviously the map is still kind of like low poly, you know, very easy to run kind of style. But the size and the scale of it makes it feel absolutely enormous. The game plays really well. It's super smooth. The map, honestly, it's really, really well done. We've got this kind of coastline cruise going over a bridge here. Oh my gosh, dude, this is sick. What do you guys think of this new map? Let me know in the comments down below. I think the scale is my favorite thing. It feels like a large map. It feels like I'm in a huge world, a full-size city. It definitely gives me the right feeling for that. You've got everything. You've got the shipping area, the airports, the beach area, everything you would ask for. It's in this map. Complete. I love it. Now then, into some different territory. We're gonna go ahead and jump out of this plane. And now we're gonna get into the water. Oh wow, I really like the water too. I've always liked the way the ocean floor looks. It does have like a realistic effect to it. Anyways, let's go ahead and pull out a boat. I believe, what boat was new? I believe the race boat was remodeled, if I'm not mistaken. So this thing looks just absolutely ridiculous. We've got the really, really nice suede leather interior. We have obviously all the controls. Okay, here we go. First person in a boat. Super neat. There's a shipping boat right there as well. Look at this view of the entire city, guys. This map and everything, it's so good. Vehicle Legends, man. This game does so much right nowadays. It's crazy. And I gotta be honest with you here. I made the mistake of assuming it wasn't that great of a game about a year ago, but so much has changed in a year. This dude has put in so much work into this game. It's pretty unreal, but yeah, this is pretty much it, guys. This is the new boat. Obviously, the model is just incredible and so detailed. The map feels enormous. Even look into the distance. Look at the mountains in the distance there. That is probably the nicest backdrop I have ever seen. Like, to be completely honest with you, some people put a really, really bad image into the background to kind of make it seem like the map is really big. This is the same thing, but really, really well done. Vehicle Legends' map does feel like it's on a giant island. I think that's the point, honestly, but they do such a good job with it. It's pretty crazy. At this point, I'm kind of just curious as to how far we can get. Let's see what we can do here. We've got this profile button as well that says like when we joined and how many races we've won. That is neat. Okay, we have left the Vehicle Legends map quite a long way away. It would be super sick if he added some Easter eggs back here. Vehicle Simulator used to do that, where he would put like a little island, a lost island. It would have some Easter eggs in it. That would be something Vehicle Legends should definitely consider adding. But yo, we are far away now. Oh my god. Okay, we've reached the end. You guys can see it here. And off the side we go. Or not? What? Okay, I guess we just continue. Are we moving? We are moving. Okay, this is kind of scary, man. We are far, far away. Okay, this is... Where is the edge? Is there no end to this map? Okay. Yeah, so... Alright, I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and drive into the sunset. I hope you enjoyed the video. I've pretty much covered everything in the update. Thank you for watching, guys. If I make it, I will see you guys in the next video. But I will just keep driving until we run out of gas. Hope you enjoyed, guys, and I hope to see you in the next video. Take care.